One of the most ambitious plans of humanity is to leave our planet and find a new one to call home. And one big step towards this big dream is colonization of Mars. Now, right from NASA, SpaceX and many other agencies are trying hard to find a way to make this possible. So in this episode of What the Science, we are going to list down the challenges that we are currently facing to achieve this feat. So without any further ado, let's get started. Mars is a favorite theme in many Hollywood movies. Many of them have put a lot of thoughts on how to reach Mars, but most of them aren't addressing the biggest question: how will we survive once we get there for a long term? The atmosphere of Mars is mostly carbon dioxide, the surface of the planet is too cold to sustain human life, and the planet's gravity is near 38% of Earth's gravity. The atmosphere on the Mars is just 1% of Earth's atmosphere at the sea level. Before talking about surviving on Mars, let's address the first problem of the entire voyage: landing on Mars. Traveling to Mars is just the first step of the journey. It will take 260 days to reach Mars. Once we get there, the major challenge will be landing on the planet's surface. Back in 2007, scientists considered four possible solutions to this problem: legged landing system based off lunar lander, sky crane landing system, airbag landing system, and touchdown sensing. 10 years later, scientists have even more ideas on how to land manned mission on Mars, but still scientists are not 100% sure about the best one to go with. Next challenge will be designing habitats. Since humans can't survive on Mars without proper habitats, so designing them with available resources on Mars will be of a great challenge. The habitat's design should be self-sustaining and capable of supporting life for an extended period of time without support from Earth. Even if we could achieve all of the stated parameters, you would have to spend the rest of your life in a closed dome. The next challenge will be growth. Keeping food and medicine supplies stocked on Mars is the best way to make a habitat self-sustaining. But with thin atmosphere and reduced sunlight, it would be difficult to get anything to grow. One possible solution can be artificial leaves. Artificial leaves are designed to work in harsh conditions. These leaves are made up of silicon rubber and can take little bit of sunlight and turn into enough power to fuel necessary chemical reactions to make medicines and other compounds. Terraforming. The first few trips to Mars will only include the essentials. One of NASA's first goal is to learn how to survive on Mars. Without more research on the planet, NASA can't say about the dangers that could threaten human life. After the first base is established, NASA can have better understanding about what needs to be done to establish humanity on Mars. Like detoxification of Martian soil, creation of greenhouses to grow plants, using water from Mars ice cap poles, etc. Scientists and enthusiasts have speculated on everything from nuking the planet into habitability, to create a magnetic shield around the planet to encourage it to grow its own atmosphere, so that humanity can finally find its new home. So that's it from this episode of What the Science. Please do share your thoughts and suggestions about this episode in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you. And if you like what we are doing, then you can support us by clicking on the red subscribe button and also the notification button to the side of it. And if you really like this video, you can click the like button also. You can watch other videos from my channel by clicking on the link above. You can follow me on other social media platforms. All the links are provided in the description below. And to continue watching more videos from my channel, you can click on the videos appearing on your screen right now. Thank you for watching.